Dear friends, in class 7 we are studying 6th chapter, the triangle and its properties, and the next point was two special triangles, equilateral and isosceles. We are studying the properties related to equilateral triangle and isosceles triangle. In try this, we asked find the angle of x in each figure. Now see the first figure. Here first figure is, we are given two sides are equal, means it is an isosceles triangle. Now please note, property of isosceles triangle is two sides are equal and angles opposite to congruent sides are congruent, or base angles are congruent. Now if base angles are congruent, then this x must be equal to 40 degrees, and therefore this x and this 40 degrees, these two angles must be equal. It means x must be equal to 40 degrees. Now if you see the second figure, here also we are given two sides are equal. It means angles opposite to congruent sides are congruent. So if this is 45 degrees, then please note it is opposite to this congruent side and this angle is opposite to congruent side. So another angle, this upside angle, is 45 degrees. Now we know that sum of interior angles of a triangle is 180 degrees. So we will get 45 plus x plus 45 must be equal to 90 degrees. So x plus 45 plus 45 is equal to 180 degrees. Now this addition we can do. It is 90 equal to 180 degrees. If you transpose 90 to the right hand side, you will get x is equal to 180 minus 90, that is equal to 90 degrees. So here in this figure, x is equal to 90 degrees. In this figure, x is equal to 40 degrees. Now see the third figure. Please note, here congruent side is, these two sides are congruent sides. So this triangle is tilted, it is rotated. Base angles are these angles. Angles opposite to congruent sides are called as base angles. It means this 50 and this x, which are opposite to congruent sides, must be equal. So here in this figure we will get x is equal to 50 degrees. Please be careful, base is not always at the bottom. In isosceles triangle, base is always opposite to congruent sides. Dear friends, we are asked to find angle x in each figure. Fourth question is, see, one of the angle is 100 degree. Please note, two sides are equal. So it does mean that angles opposite to congruent sides are congruent, or you can say base angles are equal. So it means if this angle is x, the other angle will also be x. Now we know that sum of interior angles, sum property of triangle is, sum of interior angles of a triangle is 180 degrees. It means x plus 100 equals to 180 degrees. Now this is equal to 2x plus 100 equals to 180 degrees. If you transpose 100 to RHS, you will get 2x is equal to 180 minus 100, that is equal to 80 degrees. It means x is equal to 40 degrees. Divide both sides. So you will get x is equal to 40 degrees. Now see the fifth figure. Please note, I have already told before, if there is a square at angle, it means this angle is 90 degree angle. It is a right angle. Now again we know that angles opposite to congruent sides are congruent. It means these two sides are congruent. So if one of the angle is x, then other angle must also be x, because please note, this is the angle opposite to this side and this angle is opposite to this side. 90 degrees opposite to this side. So we will get x plus 90 degree is equal to 180 degrees. That is what is the angle sum property is. Now we will get again 2x plus 90 equal to 180 degrees. Transpose 90, it will become negative. You will get 2x is equal to 180 minus 90, that is equal to 90 degrees. It means divide both sides by 2, you will get x is equal to 45 degrees. So here x is equal to 45 degrees. In third figure, please note, this triangle is again tilted. Here congruent sides are like this. Now please note, x is opposite to congruent side, so this angle, other angle must also be x degrees. Now again we know that sum of interior angles of a triangle is 180 degrees, so you get x plus x plus 40 equals to 180 degrees. It means 2x plus 40 equals to 180 degrees. So you will get 2x is equal to 180 minus 40, that is equal to 140 degrees. It means x is equal to 70 degrees. So this will be 70 degrees. The other will also be 70 degrees. 70 plus 70 is 140. 140 plus 40 is 180 degrees. So value of x is 70 degrees. Dear friends, we are asked to find angle x in each figure. Now watch carefully. This angle is given to us 120 degrees. Please note, it forms a linear pair with interior angle of a triangle. It means this 120 is an exterior angle of a triangle. Now watch carefully. This exterior angle forms a linear pair with this angle. They are angles on a single line. So their sum is 180 degrees. And please note, this angle is equal to this angle. Reason is they are opposite to congruent sides. X and this angle must also be X. The reason is they are opposite to congruent sides. Now, if this is X, X plus 120 must be equal to 180 degrees. Reason is they form linear pair. So you will get X is equal to 180 minus 120. That is equal to 60 degrees. So this x must be equal to 60 degrees. This is 60, so this other must also be 60 degrees. Dear friends, now watch carefully. In 8th figure, we have this angle as 110 degrees. Watch carefully, it forms a linear pair with this angle. It means it is an exterior angle of a triangle. It forms a linear pair with interior angle of a triangle. And we know that exterior angle is equal to sum of interior opposite angles. So watch carefully. These two sides are congruent. Angles opposite to congruent sides are congruent. If one of the angle is x, then other angle must also be x. Now exterior angle is equal to sum of interior opposite angles. Means 110 is equal to x plus x. This will be 2x. 2x is equal to 110. It means 1x is equal to 55 degrees. So here 55 degrees and 55 degrees will be the angle. Now see next third figure, ninth figure. This angle is given to us as 30 degrees. Watch carefully. It is vertically opposite angle of this triangle. When two lines intersect, these vertically opposite angles are equal. So watch carefully, here two lines are intersecting. So if one of the angle is 30 degree, other angle will also be 30 degrees. Now see, this x is opposite to congruent side. So you will get x is equal to 30 degrees. Please note, congruent angles opposite to congruent sides are congruent. So if one of the angle is 30 degree, other must also be 30 degrees, and hence x is equal to 30 degrees. Dear friends, we are trying to study two special triangles, equilateral triangle, isosceles triangle, and whatever properties we have studied earlier. Now see, we are asked to solve this. Find angles x and y in each figure. Now see, we have already studied that if two sides are equal, then the triangle is called as isosceles triangle. Here two sides are equal, so it is isosceles triangle, and the property of isosceles triangle is angle opposite to congruent sides are congruent. So if one of the angle is y, this other must also be y. Now watch carefully. Y and 120 forms a linear pair because they are angles on a single line. So y plus 120 is equal to 180 degrees. Reason is they are in linear pair. So y is equal to 180 minus 120, that is equal to 60 degrees. Now see, we have got y is equal to 60 degrees. This y is equal to 60 degrees. It means the other y must also be 60 degrees. Now, we know that exterior angle is equal to sum of interior opposite angles. So, you will get x plus y equals to exterior angle, that is 120. X plus y is equal to 120 degrees. Reason is exterior angle is equal to interior opposite angles. So you will get x is not known, y is 60 degree we have just found. So x plus 60 is equal to 120. So if you transpose 60 to the RHS, you will get x is equal to 120 minus 60, that is equal to 60 degrees. So in this case, x is also 60 degrees and y is also 60 degrees. Now see the second figure. Here, in this figure, please note, two sides are equal. It means again it is an isosceles triangle. And we have the property that angles opposite to congruent sides are congruent, that is x, the other angle will also be x. Now see, this is given to us as a square. Square means it is a right angle. So we will get sum of interior angles of a triangle equals to 180 degrees. So we have x plus 90 equals to 180 degrees. Reason is angle sum property of triangle. Angle sum property. So you will get, if you try to find the value of x, you will get 2x plus 90 equals to 180. Transpose 90 to RHS, you will get 2x is equal to 180 minus 90 is 90 degrees and x is equal to 45 degrees. Now watch carefully, we have got these 45 degrees, this also 45 degrees. Now you can use the linear pair, x plus y is equal to linear pair, that is equal to 180 degrees, or you can use the another property. This is an exterior angle. Exterior angle is equal to sum of interior opposite angles. So y is equal to x plus 90. It means 45 plus 90, that is equal to 135 degrees. Y is equal to 135 degrees. Here we are using the property, exterior angle property. Exterior angle property. Now, if you see the third figure, we have to find the value of x and y. Please note, this angle forms, or it is a vertically opposite angle of this interior angle, 92 degrees. Vertically opposite angles are equal. So, if this angle is 92 degrees, it means this is also 92 degrees. Now, we have the another property. Please note, two sides are equal. If two sides are equal, then we call the triangle as isosceles triangle. And the property of isosceles triangle is angles opposite to congruent sides are congruent. So if one angle is x, the other will also be x. It means we can have the angle sum property of the triangle. So you will get x plus 92 equals to 180 degrees. Now it means x plus x is 2x is equal to, I am transposing 92 to other side, so I will get 88 degrees. 2x is equal to 88 degrees means x is equal to 44 degrees. Now, if x is equal to 44 degrees, then we have x plus y equals to 180 degrees. Reason is linear pair. X plus y is equal to 180 degrees. Reason is linear pair. So you will get y is equal to 180 minus 44, that is equal to 136 degrees. So here value of x is 44 degrees and y is equal to 136 degrees. In this problem, we have x is equal to 45 degrees and y is equal to 135 degrees. And in first problem, we have x and y both are equal to 60 degrees.